back to TalkNorth.com. Thank you for listening. If you can, please download before you listen. It helps our business. I'd also like to thank our producer, Brandon Morton, and let you know if you'd like to sponsor this program or any of the programs on the network, you can reach me at jsouhan47@gmail.com. I'm going to need even more help from Tim Yotter than usual this week. I just got off a cruise, so I've missed all the Minnesota sports news. Tim Yotter is going to catch you up and me up on Vikings news. This is the Viking Update Show, part of the TalkNorth.com podcast network. Thanks to our producer, Brandon Morton, and our sponsors, Twill and the Edina Galleria, SodaStick.com, Tony Hoaglund, your State Farm agent, Champlin, and Bite Squad, BiteSquad.com. So tell me what training camp is going to look like this year, Tim.
Yeah, so the Vikings kind of released their – well, they released the schedule, and then they also put out some changes that are going to happen this year. What's still the same as it was last year, which was the first time that they held it at the TCO Performance Center, is about 5,000 tickets per day. 4,000 of those are free, and 1,000 of them can be purchased for reserve seating. What is a little bit different, though, is they're moving up their morning walkthrough by an hour, and they're not going to have fans at that morning walkthrough, but they will open the grounds to the public right after that morning walkthrough is concluded. Autographs, I think, are going to be of the biggest interest to fans and the way that things are changing there. No longer are they going to allow adults 19 and older to get into that formal autograph line that they have at the end of the morning practice. It's going to be 18 and under, which, you know, I get that some adults might be a little bit put off by that. But, you know, I've seen training camps for 20, 25 years where I've become convinced that adults are collecting them for sale, not all of them, but some. And I wouldn't be surprised now if we see even things that I saw in Mankato, I think back in the 90s, where I was pretty convinced that adults were giving kids binders, you know, of cards to be signed by the players. And, you know, the thinking is, well, they'll probably get them, put them on eBay or some other site that's selling them offline. So I kind of like that idea that it's just for kids, and I hope it doesn't get abused by the adults.
Well, you know, when you're a baseball beat writer, as I was for a long time, you see autograph seeking in all its forms. You see people at baseball games, see adults sending paying kids or sending kids to the front rail, you know, to be sympathetic figures who can collect autographs. You see adults sending kids into hotel lobbies to wait out players. It's really hard for a player to say no to a kid. And we all love the essence of autographing, right? Okay, you're a kid. That guy is your hero, or that woman is your hero. They sign a piece of paper for you, have a memento for the rest of your life. Well, I did that when I was a kid. But the reality of the modern economic world is that a lot of the autographs that get signed are getting put out there for resale. And somebody pointed out something really interesting to me at the PGA when I was covering the PGA tournament, Tim. They said that, you know, Phil Mickelson signs 1 million autographs, right? Well, that part of that is PR. He likes being popular with galleries. But somebody who knows him well told me it's also because he doesn't want his autograph to be able to be resold. So he tries to flood the market with as many autographs as possible so that, you know, people won't be able to go on eBay and get $100 for his signatures, which is kind of where we are with all this. So I hope that the kids who get their autographs signed aren't being used by adults. I hope that they retain some innocence in this enterprise.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, I give the players credit because I've talked to a few of them about it, and you know, they feel like they can kind of recognize the kids that are just doing that and the ones that are genuinely gleeful about getting an autograph. And that's the great part is, you know, you said you did it as a kid. I got a couple of autographs as a kid, and, you know, it was really it was something sometimes I pinned up, you know, in my room, and I would go and research that player a little bit more and get to know more about them. And so I think it's a great idea to have the kids be able to do this. And I appreciate the fact that seeing it from the other side where the players are signing it, you know, even if they know that there's a possibility that a kid is just doing this for an adult, they're still very accommodating in doing it. And I like the way that the Vikings have set it up now, where they do it by position, you know, one position a day during training camp. And, you know, it's about a half an hour, and they're signing like crazy in that half hour and maybe taking a picture or two with the kid. But, you know, it's a good experience as long as it remains pure. And I don't think it was pure for quite a while. And so I hope it is a good experience for kids just being able to do this.
And the short, easy solution to this problem is, if you take a picture with somebody, they're not going to resell that. You know, nobody's going to want a picture of a football player with somebody else's kid in it. And the other one is, if you sign it to Ben Jr. or something, you know, then that's not resellable. I mean, it takes a little bit extra time, but then it actually makes it more of a personal experience and less of a transaction.
Totally agree. A couple other things that they're doing too, and one of these involves kids. You know, it may be sort of a takeoff. Everybody probably knows that the Packers have kids they'll have kids bring bikes for the players to ride from the locker room to their practice facility or their practice fields during training camp. The Vikings being so close, you know, they just basically walk out of a locker room, walk onto the practice field. But this year they're going to do what they're calling a helmet hike, which the kids will meet the players outside of the locker room, and each kid will be able to bring a helmet from the locker room onto the field and then get a picture with that player. So I'm not exactly sure how the Vikings are going to choose which kids are able to do this, but I think it's another good idea to try to help make things a little bit more personable between the player and the kid. And then finally, the other change from last year's training camp, as things get built out around the actual practice facility that the Vikings have, there are now some office buildings in that surrounding. They are going to have what they're calling kind of a cooling house in a building. It's not the Vikings' actual where the team headquarters are, but it's on the campus right there where kids or adults can walk in, cool down. I think there's going to be an arcade for kids to play. So sort of an opportunity where if you're showing up at, say, 11:30 and the afternoon practice isn't until 2:30, you know, the kids may be getting hot or maybe some older adults are getting hot. They can go in there and cool down. So a couple other ideas that I really like as the Vikings get used to hosting their own training camp in Eagan.
Cool. Let's get to some key dates and some young players people might want to be watching once they do start training camp. Do want to thank Twill in the Edina Gallery. I was just in a hotel elevator in Florida and a guy got on with a Johnny O shirt. I bought a bunch of Johnny O stuff at Twill. They have a bunch of brands you may not have heard of that make really comfortable fitted clothing, no matter what your size or shape is. Check out twillmn.com and Twill on Instagram for pictures of everything they have to offer.
Jim usually doesn't like to shop for clothes. I don't like it when he shops for clothes either, because he used to buy stuff I'd want to throw out. That's why I'm so glad he's found Twill in the Edina Galleria. He likes shopping there because of the comfortable environment and the friendly staff. He finds clothes that actually fit him properly and are high-quality brands that will look great for years, whether he's golfing or working. Our favorites so far are Peter Millar, Johnny O, and Barber. We spend our money at Twill because we love the clothes and we love the no-pressure shopping. Drop by Twill in the Edina Galleria for the best shopping experience and best clothes you'll find in the Twin Cities.
All right, let's you know, if people are like me, they don't always want to have to Google stuff. They like having stuff written down someplace. So if you're interested in key dates for Vikings training camp, get out a pen or a pencil right now, and Tim will run through them for you.
Well, sure. The rookies are going to start a few days before the veterans, which has been sort of their practice the last several years. And when the rookies are there and it's only the rookies, then that's not open to the public. So the first date that people really need to know is July 26th. That's going to be the first full practice with veterans and rookies together and the first full practice that fans are allowed at. July 29th, the first date that the pads go on. August 3rd is going to be their night practice, and that's at the TCO Stadium right there on campus. That's a good experience. Probably the most desired ticket for training camp. And August 16th is the last day of training camp. And I should also mention, too, that they have a cap, as they did last year, on the number of tickets that can be reserved per person. So each person can reserve four tickets two different times, four tickets per day, two different times during training camp. So those will be going on sale this week. And I think season ticket holders have the first shot to reserve training camp tickets. As I said, 4,000 of them are free, 1,000 with reserved seating are, I believe, starting at $15 a day.
So last year, the Vikings went into training camp with all the excitement around Kirk Cousins, all the question, you know, all the feelings that this could be a Super Bowl team, and you had the first year of TCO. What do you think? Do you think the crowds will be lessened at all by the fact that they didn't have a great season last year and there isn't quite the newish factor with the new facility?
Possibly, but I don't see that, because I think it was mostly sold out, and I use sold, you know, kind of in quotes, because with all the free tickets. But I think mostly sold out each day. And I do think that, you know, while there probably was some kickback to the fact that it's no longer in Mankato, I think as fans get a chance to see the setup in Eagan, they realize that it's better overall. I think the viewing lines for people were better, because in Mankato, you just had the bleachers along the side of one field, and at times there would be a lot more action, a full field away, just to try to help the grass conditions there, so one field wasn't getting used all the time. So I think it's a better setup, although I think a lot of people would argue Mankato, you know, being a smaller town, has a little tighter feel to it, and you can go out to, you know, the bars and restaurants and see other people with Vikings jerseys on, and fans got to know each other and stay at the same hotels all the time. That may take some time, but I think if you're just interested in viewing practices, I really think that having it in Eagan is a really nice setup.
Oh, I agree completely. And let's face it, we love those of us who grew up going to old school training camps and grew up covering old school training camps, there was a certain charm to it. But let's face it, most Vikings fans are in the Twin Cities or traveling through the Twin Cities to get there, and it's incredibly convenient. I mean, we know how crazy Viking fans are and NFL fans are. Now you can actually, you know, find a cheap flight, fly into the MSP airport, and pop out to Eagan really easily, and that was part of the plan here.
And, you know, the other thing is, quite frankly, there's a little more to do when you're not at training camp. I mean, you go visit the Mall of America. That's only probably, you know, 5 to 10 minutes away from the Eagan facility, and all kinds of stuff to do downtown. You know, that time of year, the way the Twins are playing, good time to, you know, maybe you take in a practice in the afternoon for the Vikings and then head to the Twins game at night. I think it's a better setup overall, but you know, there's always going to be nostalgia over, you know, Mankato and the small town atmosphere and those sorts of things. But I just think, and quite frankly, you know, the Vikings are building a hotel on their campus, and eventually part of that hotel, when it's finished, is going to have a section where some of the younger players stay year round. And so it just makes a lot more sense for them to have everything on one campus.
Absolutely. Hey, thanks to SodaStick for sponsoring this program and the network as a whole. They are fairly new to this program. They have a members-only club that will get you early access and some cool deals. Just click on the members-only club signal at SodaStick.com. It's SOTA Stick.com. Soda is in the end of Minnesota. And they have cool football stuff. They always come up with new stuff. They also have great vintage stuff, including the Randy Moss Moon, the Skull hats, Skull Trucker hats. But hey, a lot, they always have stuff going on regardless of what is going on the Minnesota sports scene. So right now they have a ton of twin stuff. They have a really beautiful Minnesota golf cap. They have the Bomba t-shirts referring to the Twins home runs. And they have everything from curling to soccer to